Let me just double check. Yeah, a few seconds ago. Yep, you're good. All right. Grab it here. Should be three bottles for you.
I haven't explained anything to her, so...
Thank you.
Yeah, you're welcome.
Yeah, I would like some explanation.
All right. So take him... So when you feel stressed, just take one. So you can, if you unscrew the top of that bottle, you can get a pill. Then you can just take that pill. It will have a pretty immediate effect. But take it when you feel like you're stressed out. Just if you, like, not if you're just a tiny bit stressed. Like if you feel like it's causing you problems or in, what do you call it, inhibiting your work, then
okay.
I'd pop one.
Okay.
It should keep you calm for a while, so you wouldn't have to, you know, keep popping them. But at some point, the effect does run out, so you can just take another. Try to limit the intake, maybe two or three a day. Just to be sure.
What do you mean? And when every 3 days, you said?
No, no, you can take two or three pills per day.
Okay, all right.
If you feel more stressed, you probably could take more, but I wouldn't recommend it. Obviously, this is a trial, so we're trying to figure out, you know, a good middle ground.
I get it.
So, but it's up to you.
Have you guys noticed, like, any side effect yet, or not really?
It depends on the person. It's individual. Like, some people have nausea, some people have headaches, some people have, you know, they feel cold. So I'm assuming maybe they're catching a fever, but it's just the usual. So it's like one out of every 10,000 and one out of every 100. So there's no severe side effects, as far as I know. We had one that had an allergic reaction, which can turn into something, you know, more severe. But at the end of the day, they shouldn't kill you.
Oh, that's good, right?
Yes, we haven't had any fatalities.
I'll make sure to keep an eye out for that one.
All right, that sounds good.
Okay, do you guys want us to, like, write how we feel when we take it, or you guys are gonna ask us a little bit later?
If you can keep notes, that would be great, but I'll do a follow-up in like 14 days, roughly. If you run out or if anything comes up, you can always reach out. We can do a refill.
Okay, that's cool. All right. Well, I appreciate it. Thank you for trusting me with that. That's cool.
Yeah, of course. You just want to make sure you guys are, you know, not having to deal with stressed out situation when you're on duty.
That's fair.
Yeah.
God knows we get into a lot of shit every day, huh?
Yep.
Okay, I'm gonna head out on patrol, and if there's anything, I'll reach out. Thank you very much.
All right, sounds good.
All right, take care.
Bye-bye. All right, now we just need snow, and I should be good. This is where I dropped the bombshell that I'm bringing Reggie on to help with the company.
He's probably still up there staring at the sky.
All right. So what? You want to talk about it?
About what?
You know what?
What?
Your house being empty. You don't want to get your cars.
Oh, my house is always empty.
Okay.
No, I just got a ride to work yesterday and then I ran home.
Uh-huh. Okay. Nothing. Don't want to talk about it. I'm not going to pry.
There's nothing to talk about.
I don't believe that. Should I tell Reed to turn himself in?
I don't care what he does. He's done the paperwork. It doesn't matter.
All right.
Do what he wants. He's just gonna get a warrant, and then HGV goes after him, and then he deals with HGVU, which is a lot harsher than I am.
It sounds like
I'll make it easier on him.
I'm surprised Reed hasn't called.
Guess he doesn't want to chit chat.
I was like, Reed.
Oh. Not gonna go away, so it's up to him.
So what is she even upset about, I wonder? Sure you don't want to talk about it?
I don't know if you do want to talk about it. That's the thing.
What do you mean you don't think I want to talk about it?
You probably do what everyone else does, run away from it.
Huh. What?
Don't worry about it.
Well, that was too late because now I know that you're lying when you're saying there's nothing wrong. Might as well just spit it out.
Spit it out?
Okay, you might as well just explain it to me so I can figure out what's going on so we can fix it.
Not fixable.
It's not fixable. How is it not fixable?
No. It's not fixable. It's not something you can put a band-aid over and be like, oh, it'll get better.
Everything is fixable.
Not that.
Yes, God damn it.
Come on, snowman.
Okay, well, if it's not fixable, then tell me. So we can make it at least better.
No, because what has to happen is just I need to deal with it. And the way I'm going to have to deal with it is just having to be stronger and learning the word no.
Learning the word no.
Yes.
Someone asked. No. Did someone ask you to do something and you didn't say no?
Everyone asks me to do stuff and I don't say no.
Well, you did
earlier. Solving positions. When?
When Reggie called.
What?
What? Well, you didn't. Okay, you didn't say no, but you declined the offer.
Yeah, because I don't want to end up. I don't know. You're not gonna like what I have to say, so it's rather that I deal with it or it's just gonna cause drama between us.
Okay. Why do I. So this has to do with me, is what you're saying.
It has to do with everyone.
Uh-huh.
It has to do with me.
Then explain it. Probably get a shift for working.
I'm lonely.
No, I don't think
so. That's it. I'm lonely and I bend over backwards for everyone and get nothing in return and I'm sick of it. That's it. That's it. I'm lonely. And I realized that the night that you were like, oh, take me home, and the night that Bree called, and I realized that I was just the same thing that I had with Pred and Angel over again with other people.
God
damn
it, Jenny.
I bend over backwards for them. I do what I think because I think I'm going to get something in return, and I don't. And I'm lonely, and I'm fed up. Are you happy now?
Yeah. It means it's something that can be worked on.
Yeah, it can be, by me turning you all down.
What, so you're saying you don't want to hang out?
It's not what I'm...
Okay, that's, first of all, using the take me home is not fair.
How is it not?
Because.
You have a girlfriend. Like, she should be doing that. Why should she be doing everything for you?
God damn. Nikki, please. Can't use that.
Right.
Oh, why is she always like this? I still feel like that one is very unfair.
Why is it?
Why is it that it's unfair to use that example?
Just the Strahler quote about the coming back. It's not like an issue with it. It's just a long list of things that was what broke it. It actually wasn't even that broke it. It was Reed. It was Reed calling me and going, hey, come help me. Not for any reason for me, just because he needed me and I was and like, because I would. That was it. Because I would.
Yeah, but you shouldn't lump Reed in with everyone else.
No, I'm lumping everyone together because I've just done this for a whole year of my life with Pred and Angel, and I don't want to go into it with other people as well.
What have you done with Pred and Angel? Like, exactly.
I was the fucking middleman I did everything for Pred. I was his right-hand woman. I was the middleman. And they fucking used me for all it was worth.
Okay, so don't shut up.
And run off together and act like it's fucking them two. And I'm like, okay, ban cool.
You. And then you
I've
have
just
to
lost my entire
account.
Support system. That's cool. It's complicated and hard, and I've got to deal with it. I didn't even want to talk about it.
All right, fair. Like I said, I want to pry. If you don't want to talk about it, that's fine. I thought we were doing better. Like, we talked about that, what? Was that yesterday? Was it the day before? Like, for once in my life, I'm not donut walling. I'm actually calling you daily. And I'm trying to not, you know... When I call you, I try to... I forgot the word. To not make it about work, because I know you hate that. I also try not to use you for any cop-related stuff, because I know you hate that. I called you yesterday in regards to company stuff because you are on the board and you are an investor, so I thought it was a good idea to talk to you, especially
because... Yeah, I don't have a problem with that.
Okay. No, I know what she's saying. That everyone is relying or asking her to do stuff without giving anything back. But it's not that. Jenny has a tendency to not call. If she needed something and called Michael, you wouldn't
just... I'm
gonna
run upstairs and see if he's still sitting on the roof.
He's about to take off, I feel like.
Nope, that's him.
Oh, alright.
That is... That's Tails.
Alright. I'll wait here. Sad walk. I feel like it's a bit in the same way as Nick and Bunny, but I think Nick is much just more clueless. But I think in Nick and Bunny's case, I think Nick is just more clueless. Because it's hard to give her the time of day if she doesn't ask or reach out, right? A second choice to everyone. Y'all need to make up your fucking mind, because everyone keeps saying, poor Flossie. You can't say poor Flossie and poor Jenny. You ain't got that choice. Yes, we can. Fuck off. Also, it's unfair that she's using the fucking tsunami thing. That's unfair. Oh, fuck me. What if we want Jenny in the Trouble instead of Benji? You're gonna piss off Flossie even more. Molly was just, you know, Molly was a person that just kind of came out of nowhere. Jenny has a history, which probably makes it worse. Did I just see? Wait, what am I hearing? I just heard Reed. Just spend time? Well, they did spend time. But it's also hard when Jenny works half the time. Get her some flowers. Y'all the motherfuckers. More ride-alongs.
I don't think he's gonna be available for a while.
Okay.
He's not even. He's just there, just out there, existing, and has been for about.
What is Snow doing?
28 minutes.
Okay. All right. Okay. Well. I'll probably be heading out, so I'm gonna say whenever he's done, we can get the contract sorted, and whenever you want to sit down and have a drink and we can talk about it, just let me know. See? That's nice, right? Have a drink, sit down and talk. That's what people do. You can't say that was bad. Come on. That took Michael a lot of effort to say. Was the hawk? I don't think that is the situation for a hawk. You don't just... L-wrist? It's not a wrist thing. This isn't a wrist thing. This is not Nick. More like elf friend. Sir. You all think that Michael, look, so Nick is obviously clueless. Mick is less clueless, but he's still kind of clueless. Like, at least, you know. Well, he used to be able to let people into his fucking life until people just stabbed him in the back. Well, here's the thing. If you think about it, their background makes it so they would have to deal with that shit, not having emotions, relationships, etc., etc. Like, they're military trained people that were put through hell to toughen them up, etc., etc. Michael is more clueless. Okay. That's fucked up. Is that good? Huh? Can you approve that? That he's prioritizing it more than work? No? Okay, you're off. Alright. No message then. Wouldn't even send a text right now. Well, now I'm not going to say anything because chat is telling me what to do. Fuck. I don't know what to write. And ChatGPT it? Oh, yeah, that's gonna end well. That's going to end super well. Yeah. Like, as much as it's fair that she's feeling that way, Jenny also has a tendency to not reach out the other way. When was the last time Jenny called Michael to, you know, hang out? She checks up on him in text messages, but... Yeah, she was there, and she checks up on him, but, like, calling and asking to hang out. Alright, you know what? I'm gonna make it this way. I'm gonna do it this way. I'm going to set... I'm gonna to find a date where we sit down and talk while having a drink or two. No is not an option. Even if it's just to be in each other's company. That good? I think that needs some context. There you go. Now you can't complain. So what is Snow doing exactly? He was watching clips. Oh. Looking through all clips. That's fair. All right, I'm gonna end today. I'm gonna end early. You can't drink. Oh my, Jenny. She is pushing back. The fuck set. You fucked up, buddy, not just on Twitch. Not a no? No, but it's still a pushback. It's still an excuse. All right, now I'm going. All right, chat. Early day for me. I wasn't even sure if I was going to stream or not. I'll be maybe back on Friday. I do have a lot of work I need to catch up on. So if not Friday, then weekend. But we'll see. We'll see. I'll send you guys off to... Nikki. Would make sense. But yeah, thank you so much for hanging out. I know it can be slow, but hey, roleplay is roleplay, and I like to not go around and shooting everyone. Slow burn is fun. But yeah, all right, I'll see you guys on Friday, hopefully. Have a good rest of your day. And let's